Welcome to WTF Red, the only AskReddit channel that will blow your mind. Like and subscribe right now to support Pepe's career as an independent musician. r/AskReddit by iReddit. What are some huge green flags that are often overlooked? When you're not afraid to disagree with them. Because you know they'll actually listen, rather than just hurting you. Edit. Thanks for the gold and silvers. Kind strangers. Complimenting others behind their backs. That the person is actually listening to you. When someone admits to their mistake slash owning up to it, and does not make an excuse for failing, but trying to better themselves through that experience. Being positive about it. General mindfulness. The little things you don't really notice, if you don't pay attention. Pushing a chair in, after sitting in it. Asking questions and being involved with you. You can learn a lot about somebody, by paying attention to how they listen. And having a partner that listens, is an absolutely amazing feeling. There is a huge gap between being aware of what you're saying, and understanding what you're saying. A good listener is priceless. Someone reading a book you recommend. That's commitment of free time and respect for your word. My boyfriend will sometimes be upset, and start a sentence with "well you." And then takes a second and starts over with "I feel." I notice every time and I try, and be the same way. When they don't make you feel guilty for occasionally wanting to do things by yourself. Edit. Thanks for the silver. When you're talking with someone, and they remember what you're talking about, or were talking about at one point. Another one is, when they remember, that you've done certain things with them, and bring it up from time to time. Other than that, it's the normal stuff that shouldn't be overlooked, or the little things I guess. When someone is quick to give credit and slow to place blame. Such a great sign, that someone will celebrate other people, and appreciate slash acknowledge them. And will be really kind and benevolent when something bad happens. Pushing a chair in at a public establishment when you leave. Learns the small things about you. Treating people you don't have to treat respectfully. Asterisk WITHRESPECT asterisk. I'm currently an Uber Eats driver and I've found a huge contrast in the manner hospitality staff treat me when I'm picking up orders. Compared to when I'm a customer. It seems because I'm not a paying customer. Service staff seem to think it's okay to treat me like shit or a lesser individual. When someone can admit they're wrong. Edit. My first silver. Thank you, anonymous redditor. Bangladesh. Edit. I would have never expected this to get a gold. But thank you, kind stranger. When they show genuine interest in you, or what you're doing. They listen to you go on and on about shit they don't care about, and don't understand, because they know you enjoy talking about it. Putting the used grocery cart back where it's supposed to go. Treating people in services jobs as equals. Using that weird flashy light on your car, before you merge your turn. Edit. First Reddit silver. Thank you. Admitting when they don't understand something, and asking questions about it until they do. A few years ago I was at a party with a friend of mine. And another friend of a friend who is a physicist who worked for a startup, that produced specialized magnets for quantum computing. My friend asked the startup guy about his work. And he explained it. And everybody else in the room just nodded and acted, like they knew what he was talking about. But she said, "I don't understand. Can you explain that a different way?" And he did. And then she kept asking questions for quite a while. And by the end of it, we actually all did understand what his company did instead of just being polite and pretending we did. And it was super interesting. A couple of people thanked her afterward basically for having the self-confidence to admit she didn't have any clue what he was talking about and not being afraid it would make her look dumb. Because the rest of us were all content to pretend we knew instead of actually taking the initiative to find out. I respected her so much for that. Good communication. If you can communicate really well with someone, that is huge. Quality communication between two people can be way more important in a relationship than compatibility, and is a huge part of good chemistry. For example, one of my friends has gone on a couple dates with this one girl and the first date they talked for 3 hours and the second date they talked for 4 hours. But he's not sure if he wants to see this girl again. Like what? Putting their rubbish in the bin. when they leave a place like Macca's / Hungry Jack's / KFC / fast food places. Like honestly, a child knows how to put their rubbish in the bin. Why are you leaving your rubbish everywhere if you're a grown adult? Question mark? How they treat ex-partners or taught they exes did them wrong. No feelings of wanting revenge. One of the reasons I decided to move in with my now boyfriend. Edit, little clarification. This isn't about shit talking in private. That's emotional and understandable if something nasty happened. This is about what the person decides to focus on then, and if they deliberately try to destroy and ruin their ex's life. Threatening and stalking, and just trying everything to make it extra hard when they just want to move on. And I think this says a lot about a person in general, and about how they deal with rejection and failure. Giving people the benefit of the doubt, and not being so quick to hate and hold grudges. One mistake or one bad day does not define a person. People doing kind or generous things they don't expect praise for. Like secret gifts or acts of service. Someone who's meticulously careful with a borrowed possession and returns it in pristine condition. Too many people have a cavalier attitude and just presume it's a frivolity, but this solicitous person is grateful and returns it punctually because they know it's their implicit obligation. They care about how you'd feel if something was returned damaged. It, things normal people do without thinking twice about it, because it's fucking normal to don't be an asshole. Smiling when you make eye contact with people briefly. Then you mutually smile back. Some old guy said hey to me while we were passing. That was just magical. Makes me want to do that myself. Edit, you can smile at people and not make it awkward. Smiling at people can be one of the most refreshing and socio-positive thing that you can do. If you feel uncomfortable doing it, it's fine. You will get used to it. This was a good experience. Don't comment on how an elderly person smiling at me is considered a red flag or creepy. It didn't make me uncomfortable. Being honest and vulnerable, especially in men. Honesty early on. When my husband and I started dating, I told him how much I wanted to see a certain movie. And for one of our first dates, he invited me over to watch said movie and said he'd make dinner for me. I was a little nervous to go, because I figured he'd meant watch a movie. I get inside. He's got pasta cooking. And the movie is all set up and ready on his TV. We ate terrible pasta. Or creepy. And that was the day I decided to keep seeing him, but that I'd do the cooking. I noticed once I got into my 30s that all my friends would break up over green flags. OC was doing my high dishes. Like, bitch, back off. He was just always asking me how I was doing and trying to be deep. So annoying. She just was too something, IDK. She got me a birthday card and said asterisk I love you asterisk. He kept trying to see me every week. Then when I said no, he didn't call me for a whole week. She wanted to date, but she said she also was focused on working 5 days a week. I need her asterisk commitment asterisk to me. Edit, okay. A handful of comments about why I'm friends with them, if these people are so horrible / terrible / selfish etc. Asterisk. Asterisk, I have worked with many of them for over a decade. And as anyone knows who has held down a long-term job, sometimes you make friends with people, even if they have character flaws, if you see them every day for years. Asterisk. Asterisk THESE people all have individually donated thousands of their dollars to local charities. And all have volunteered to help with adopting struggling families, domestic abuse survivors, children's charities, etc. I have watched them pull out hundreds of dollars from their wallet on the spot to help support a co-worker who is sick, injured, or just had a child and have to take unpaid time off. Most of them will drop anything they're doing to come and help you if you're in bind. A friend came and told me, 120 miles from where we live, another not only fixed an exhaust issue on my truck, but fabricated a brand new flow through and helped install it and refused payment of any kind. Asterisk. People can be selfish, shallow, rude, etc. They can also be incredibly generous and kind at the same time. We all have character flaws. Ask that they don't have a TikTok account. Thanks for tuning in for this WTF Red episode. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the one and only AskReddit channel that will blow your mind every time.